Praise be to our God of Israel. I thank my Lord Jesus Christ for giving me life to be a part of this Golden Jubilee celebration of our Chief Pastor, my Dr. Ruth Vasu. I'm indeed grateful to our President of MPM Mission, Reverend Dr. Stanley Vasu, for giving us this opportunity to be a part of this celebration by sharing a few thoughts about our Pastor, ma. I'm just going to share three important things of our Pastor, ma, which I personally observed in her life during my ministry under her leadership during the past few years. Firstly, about her spiritual concern for the children, youngsters, men and women, and the elderly people in the church. I've been personally invited to take care of the Vacation Bible School, the VBS, which is conducted every May. She used to come and talk with me and ask me whether all the portions have been covered. And also, one important thing is, normally in all the places, the VBS will be conducted only during the morning before the lunch, and it will end with the lunch. But here in the headquarters church, it will continue till the evening, and two times the snacks will be given, and she will make it very sure that the snacks has been given to every children. So she had a spiritual concern for the children. Not only that, for the youngsters too. She used to conduct special prayers, anointing sessions for the youngsters. And she used to ask me, how's their personal walk with God? Or are they reading the Bible every day? So she was having a spiritual concern for the youngsters in the church. Also, special Friday prayer meetings have been conducted for the women. And year-ending three-day special prayers for the believers also have been conducted. So through all these things, I personally witnessed that our Pastor Ma was having a spiritual concern. As a Chief Pastor Ma, also she had the spiritual concern for all the branch churches overall. Secondly, I want to talk about her sincere care for the poor and needy, for the helpless and the hopeless, for the orphans and the widows. Whenever I visited the headquarters church, and I have seen the meetings have been thronged sometimes with the poor and needy and the widows and the orphans. And, you know, she used to personally give sometimes the food packages to the people who are in need. And financial assistance also have been rendered to them. So it has also taught me that we need to have the concern for the poor in the society and inside the church. And thirdly, I've observed her the significant character, the simple dress code. Though she is the pastor for the Empire Mission, she has never had a gorgeous you know, dressing up. She had a very simple dress code. Always I've observed the white sari or white beige saris. Secondly, her exemplary lifestyle, the example lifestyle, simple dress code, example lifestyle, and the humble conversations. She has never exaggerated herself as the superintendent pastor, never. She was so humble. She has talked with me personally, though I was so young. Still, she used to give some spiritual suggestions. So, the simple dress code, the example lifestyle, exemplary lifestyle, and the humble conversations. All these things put together in this Golden Jubilee, I wish her good health and long life. May God bless her with these things. Once again, I thank the Chief Pastor, President, Reverend Dr. Stanley Vasu, for giving us this opportunity to share a few thoughts about our beloved Pastor, Dr. Ruth Vasu. Thank you. Thank you.